Version 15 of the 89600 VSA software brings the ability to run multiple measurements concurrently and view the results together. Each measurement is performed on data acquired from measurement hardware. The VSA provides three basic acquisition styles: shared acquisition, independent concurrent acquisition, and independent non-concurrent acquisition. This video will cover these acquisition styles in more detail, as well as give an in-depth example for the shared acquisition style. The shared acquisition style is where multiple measurements analyze the same time record acquired from a single instrument. In this example, the radio is transmitting three separate carriers, which are located relatively close in frequency. This signal is fed into an instrument, and all carriers of interest are captured within the instrument's analysis bandwidth. The time record is then sent to the 89600 VSA software, where it is made available to four measurements. First is the overall measurement, which looks at the combination of the three carriers. Then there are the GSM, WCDMA, and LTE measurements that shift and resample the time record to place the carrier of interest at the center. One advantage of this acquisition style is that measurements are exactly time synchronized, since they all share the same time record. Let's dig a little deeper into shared acquisition with an example. As described on the previous page, we'll have four measurements: an overall vector measurement, a GSM measurement at 1850.8 MHz, a WCDMA measurement at 1855 MHz, and an LTE measurement at 1862.4 MHz. The combined bandwidth of these three signals is about 15 MHz, which fits into the 25 MHz analysis bandwidth of the MXA I am using. Okay, let's look at this signal using the VSA software. In the measurements dialog, you can see the four measurements listed, as well as a visual representation of their relative center frequencies and spans. I'm going to close the measurements dialog for now so we can see behind it. The lower three traces show the spectrum and constellations for each signal format that is present, giving a visual indication of quality. On the top right are the error summary traces with the EVM metric visible, giving a numerical indication of signal quality. The trace in the upper left shows the overall spectrum of the GSM, WCDMA, and LTE carriers. Overlaid on the spectrum is a CCDF plot, which shows the peak-to-average statistics for all three signals combined, which can be helpful in designing a multi-carrier power amplifier. Each of the carriers is set to the same power relative to the others. Notice that the average EVM for LTE is about 1%, and the EVM for WCDMA is about 4%. Now I will increase all carriers' power by 3 dBm and rerun the measurements. Notice that the LTE signal EVM has increased by about 1 percentage point, but the WCDMA signal has not increased significantly. I will again increase the power by 3 dBm and run the measurements. Notice that the LTE EVM is now 4 points different than the initial value of 1%, but WCDMA is only different by about 2.5 points. Since each carrier's EVM degrades at different rates, we can deduce that the relative carrier powers are probably not set optimally for this multi-carrier power amplifier. The 89600 software's multi-measurement capability allows you to perform a combined analysis of multiple signals, and, in this scenario, enables you to find the optimal operating point more easily and quickly, because you can perform all these measurements simultaneously. The independent concurrent acquisition style is where multiple measurements acquire their data concurrently from different instruments. Here we have a radio that transmits a combination of GSM and Bluetooth. However, the frequency separation between the two carriers can be greater than the analysis bandwidth of a single instrument. So, we can split the signal and use two instruments to capture the time data at separate center frequencies. The time data would then be sent to the VSA software and demodulated by separate measurements. Acquisition styles can also be combined. For example, if the radio also transmitted a WCDMA signal that was close in frequency to the GSM signal, the time capture from the first analyzer could be shared between a GSM and a WCDMA measurement. Note that if you want stricter time alignment between time records, you could configure the measurements to use external triggering and then send a trigger signal to all instruments after they are waiting for trigger. For a more in-depth explanation of this scenario, see the video named Troubleshooting Interactions in a Multi-Standard Radio. Independent concurrent acquisition can also be used for any case where there are signals at physically separate test points. For example, if you have two separate antennas, or if you want to compare results between different points in the RF chain, such as baseband versus RF, or other combinations. This way allows you to pinpoint the source of the problem by measuring EVM at each point to see where it increases significantly, or by measuring CCDF to find the source of clipping. Lastly, we have independent non-concurrent acquisition. This style is different from the previous two styles in that the measurements do not run concurrently but are sequenced instead. This sequencing can be done through the 89600 VSA software's SCPI interface or the .NET API, or you could do it manually by selecting a measurement to run one at a time. One scenario where this acquisition style would be useful is where you have two signals that are separated in frequency by more than the analysis bandwidth of the instrument, but you only want to use a single instrument. Another scenario is where you have two measurements. One measurement, which requires many measurement sweeps with a short time record, and the other measurement, which requires only a few measurement sweeps, but a long time record. Running these two measurements concurrently would merge their requirements, causing many long time captures to be taken, increasing the overall test time. Instead, you could write a macro to run the measurements in sequence. Also, since both measurements can reside in memory simultaneously, you won't incur the time of setting up a measurement when switching. In summary, we went over the three basic acquisition styles. Shared acquisition, where you have multiple measurements that share the time record from a single instrument. Independent concurrent acquisition, where you have one instrument per measurement. And independent non-concurrent acquisition, where you sequence the measurement's access to a single instrument. For more information about the 89600 VSA software, including how to purchase, see the product homepage at www.edgelant.com/find/89600_VSA.